the last episode, we discussed how writing is a journey that needs to be cultivated from 15 months of age and nurtured all the way till about 6 years of age in the life of a child. We also discussed how there are 5 stages which aid the development of handwriting in children. In today's video, let's get into this issue a little deeper. If you have not already watched part 1 of this series of how to teach your children how to write, please do watch it right now. Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of Get Set Parent with Pallavi. On my channel, I discuss a variety of issues pertaining to at-home learning, emotional development, technology-based issues, and so much more, which I'm sure will help you in your parenting journey with your child. Don't forget to press the bell icon and subscribe to my channel to stay updated with all my frequent videos. So hurry up and press the subscribe button now. Now let's come to what do we call pre-writing skills. So during this journey of 15 months to 5 years, there's a lot that we as parents or teachers can do to our children to help them become more confident writers. And these are called pre-writing skills. So pre-writing skills basically improve the finger muscle strength of the children. They improve what we call fine motor skills. They improve dexterity and they improve pincer grip control. Pincer grip is basically the grip between your index finger and your thumb. When you pick something like this, it is called a pincer grip. So from a baby who is used to keeping the hand flat and open or clenched in a fist, slowly when they start perfecting the pincer grip, that's where writing confidence improves. So we need to do a variety of activities with them which improve all of these areas of building strength and control in their hand. Like I said, we do it step by step before we want the masterpieces out of our children. So some of the activities which I can suggest to you which improve all of this are all very easily available at home, and you don't need to spend a ton of money buying extra learning aids, right? So take them into your kitchen, give them some dough to play with. So it could be atta, it could be maida, put some water in, put some food color to make it more fun, and allow them to work that dough. So dough, clay play, all of this, that whole squeezing motion, the rolling motion, when they are kneading and making a roti, all of these work incredible magic on building the strength of the hand. There are other activities also which work very well. For example, if you give your child some big beads, a shoelace, and ask them to bead the beads into a shoelace and make a nice necklace. So this process of holding a lace, picking up a bead and aiming and putting it into that lace is an incredible activity to build focus, concentration, and it improves pincer grip control, right? You can also do lacing. Lacing is again a simple shoelace going up and down. There are lacing tools available, but very easily, if you want to make it at home, you take a cardboard, punch holes into it, big holes, and ask your child to go up and down. So beading, lacing, kneading, making long snakes, all of these are huge activities which help in pre-writing skills, right? Another activity which works very well is using tongs, right? Tongs or tweezers, when you ask your child to pick up an object and transfer it into another place using the tongs, again, you are building a lot of finger muscle strength. The next, again, a great pre-writing activity, safety scissors and cutting. The more your child is adept at cutting and controlling the opening and closing movement of the scissors, the stronger the finger muscles of the child get. Always remember that the bones and muscles of the hand are not fully developed and they are growing as the child grows. So there will be a lot of pain, the child will complain about difficulty, and it is real. Never brush away your child or disregard when they say that their fingers are paining. It is real and it is true. However, our job as parents is to constantly allow them and aid them in finger muscle control. So some more activities which you can try are opening and closing of clothespins, the normal clothes pegs that we use, or it could be opening and closing of bottle caps. It could even be, finger food. When you have a baby of 1 or 1.5 years, they like to pick up their food and eat it by themselves. All of these are massive aids in finger muscle development, which help the child become more confident when it comes to their writing capability. One of the most frequent questions I get is on the confusion of whether the child is right-handed or left-handed. Now, this is a very important aspect, and we have a role as parents to play here. A child will naturally start demonstrating a dominant hand. So the dominant hand or the dominant side is that which, when you provide a reflex, the child will move with that side first. So if you want to test that, put a ball in front of your child and see with which leg the child kicks the ball. So if it is right, the child's dominant side is the right side, right? So while we recognize that a majority of the population of the world is right-handed, it is a fact that we also have the lucky left-handers as well. When your child is insisting on using his or her dominant hand, which is the left side, observe carefully. And once you realize that this is indeed true, do not try and discourage your child from using the left hand. When you force a child, a left-handed, naturally left-handed child, to become a right-handed child, it can cause a lot of other complicated issues like confidence-based issues, even behavioral issues like stammering, stuttering, and a whole host of other problems. So never force a child into becoming something he is not, principally, and the same goes even for writing. So observe carefully what is the dominant side and encourage your child to use only that side. So thank you so much, and I'll see you soon on the next episode. Before you go away, please don't forget to subscribe by pressing the bell icon, following me on Instagram and Facebook as well. Thank you and take care.